It's time to continue working. A little more shopping to do. Get more matte medium. Something to cover all this up and protect it. And varnish. Matte varnish. So the brothers in Chicago talking about sickle cell today. It's really nice to see more people coming out and talking about the issues we face. It's encouraging. September is going to be a busy month for me. So I have to get stuff done right now while I have the time. Share the stream. I know there's something out there that's probably that could probably share the streams automatically instead of me having to do this sharing part. Should work. Mm-hmm. should be enough. Like and share the video for awareness. Mostly only focus on my art. So I'm not gonna see my face on a little tiny window talking. I really don't care about promoting myself. It's mostly about doing the work, talking about sickle cell, or letting the art speak for itself. There's enough pain out there. I just want to focus and don't get too down about life. Everything is good. Can get to work. And it took about 7 or 8 minutes. Get started. But I'll find a better way to do it. I cut this. Should do something if I feel air bubbles, which I feel right here. That could be trouble later. It's not cool. this year. Oh, wow. Air bubbles are not good. I didn't want to wet this too much. If I put more water on it, it could have been. I do this, the more bubbles I feel. So. Put the clear. I just came back from the art store. That was a nice sale on the matte medium and the thing is 40% off. Get a couple bottles and some brushes. Some isolation medium and some varnish. Just a few bottles. With 40% off. And the brushes 50% off. And a $10 coupon. Still spent $120 for a couple bottles. Art is expensive. But most of the time I work on sickle cell. For the awareness, it's not like I sell sickle cell pieces. It's just what you deal with life. Not looking for people to appreciate that's what you do, but they don't know this thing costs a lot of money. Sacrifices and stuff. At least this project was funded by a client, so I'm not really spending too much out of pocket. But it is still a shocking thing to be spending $120 on a couple bottles of matte medium. Just soak in for a while and see if it can take care of the air bubbles on its own and stick to the back. And there won't be too much trouble with the air bubble thing. These pieces are supposed to fit on a larger piece. And they're going to be hidden, like a secret part of the whole work. So that's not the primary part of the work. It's just a super secret part of the work. Won't be able to see that until maybe the end of the year when it's all done. Talking about December or early January. When everything is done. That's all I'm gonna talk about today. I'm gonna just continue working. Hopefully I didn't miss any more. Air bubbles. Some air bubble friends over here. So I have to cut the edges of this. This air bubble over here is gonna be trouble. Working on it last night, but it won't stick. Let's allow this to dry and see if we can take your air bubbles later. I'm not focusing on this right now. Let's do some cutting. For air bubbles. Oh yeah, air bubbles everywhere. Always feels like, oh man, I'm cutting into this thing. Normally you don't cut art. That's crazy. But how are you gonna get puzzle pieces? Take some fabric, print it. Like a canvas. Cutting on your own canvas. Oh, this works better when it's dry. Yesterday I cut it wet and it was nasty. Not everything looks as smooth. Go, nice smooth edges. I have to clean the edges because I still want this to fit with the rest of the art. Adding anything to the edges means it won't fit properly. So don't give me a hard time. anybody's wondering, these, my work is printed on cloth. Well, printed on cloth, not painted, I would say. So bad to cut out the chains from this piece. Such an important part of the imagery. After a while, this X-Acto knife starts getting a little dull, too much resistance from cutting. So I switch over to a fresh one. Hopefully it cuts. There you go. Like butter. So the knife gets dull real fast, even if it's not wet. So. I'm gonna come from the other side. Wow, there's a crazy elbow move over here.
got some coin to go with Razor Sharp. Up these edges are really good. Of what I was using for the matte medium is leaking on the sides. It's gonna be trouble for when they need to stick together. And I need to fit them together. This is not a comfortable seat. Careful here. When I talk about air bubbles, part of it not sticking to the wood. I'll go back and fix all that. Fix this English part. It's time to go switch blades. is this tarot is a scam dude doing on my stream? What? Of course tarot is a scam. That's very smart. Of course it is. Of course, Terrell is a scam. What's it look like? This is why I want to turn off my chat when I'm working. I'm not really looking at the chat. But then you have all these dumb people posting nothing that has relating to anything that you're doing. They just want to spam something stupid. What wisdom does tarot with a scam? Tarot is a scam. Really teach anybody? So many things to fight out in the world, issues. You wanna fight tarot cards. For what? I have a very interesting history with tarot cards. You know, being a depressed kid, dealing with sickle cell, and I was homeless. You have to get social workers to help you out. And one of the things they did to get me to talk to a psychiatrist and to deal with my mental health, my depression, with dealing with sickle cell. And one of the doctors I talked to, really nice guy, but he wrote a book on tarot cards. And he's like, you're an artist, you should create a tarot cards about Haiti and voodoo and all that kind of stuff. And the card deck is like 72 cards, so that would be like 72 paintings. I read his book, he gave me a free copy of his book about tarot cards and a deck of how to read them. And yeah, I saw like that tarot card reader in the James Bond movie where he faked the deck by putting the one card lovers to become the entire deck and trick the lady, the tarot card reader, into sleeping with him. When she lost her virginity, she would lose her powers or something. Yes, tarot cards. Tarot is a scam. Scam. That's the name of the guy who's posting on my chat right now. At least I should be grateful I had one viewer. one person watching. Of course, tarot is a scam. Everything is made in some capacity to benefit someone else, tricking someone else's knowledge, or taking advantage of someone else's ignorance. That's why learning and discerning fiction is important. We believe in a lot of crap as human beings. We do. And we take life for granted by not exploring our world and understanding how it works, using science and critical thinking and figuring out that some things we believe in take a lot of magic. We believe in magic. And we don't understand about how weird that is. I can't snap my finger and make all my problems go away, but that's basically what we try to do in this world. By whispering to something and we thinking, yeah, that's going to fix everything. I would rather be listening to music instead of ranting while I work. But thanks to YouTube, they're just going to copyright strike my video just because I'm listening to some cool music. From it, since I have so many air bubbles sticking out of all over the place, causing me to cut this all improper. I've been thinking about shutting down my Patreon. Patreon is a page that you go to where people donate a dollar. And, you know, they support your art or whatever you're creating. I've had this for a couple of years now, and it's like you'll have 12 people. Most Patreon pages have thousands of people supporting them. I was thinking about maybe help me to pay my rent, never be afraid of becoming homeless again and all that kind of stuff while you're dealing with sickle cell and all. But when you have like 12 to 20 folks supporting you, it's not enough to get your supplies and do the things that you need to do. But for years you have these 12 people who are supporting you, and like you have to feel grateful that they're helping you. Well, one of them is my nurse, or at least a friend, a good friend. Right. And he's, you know, donating $20 a month, like for a couple of years. And there's like 12 people there who's donating $2, $1, and stuff like that. But it's like you would rather have like 20 more people donating a dollar than you don't just one person donating 20. So I've been thinking of shutting it down, even though I still need the help. But people don't know how to use Patreon. It's like, at least my community don't know how to support art and stuff like that on Patreon. They would rather send you PayPal or GoFundMe or something. Or I'm trying to drop hints, like, get my nurse to stop supporting me for $20 and just stop, so I don't have to shut down the Patreon, because I have a lot of posts on there. I don't know how to shut it down from people donating and still keep my post, my blog post. I'm trying to figure it out. But I do want to stop getting funding or help from Patreon, because it's not really working. Like I was ranting before, all these supplies cost a lot of money. I don't always want to keep working on sickle cell stuff. I want to do some of my own stuff, but somebody paid for all these supplies, because this is a commission piece that I'm creating for a company. They happen to care about the sickle cell message because they have their own interests. They're creating tools and products and medicine for our community. So I find that's important, to keep people focused and trying to support that by agreeing to do a commission, which I never do. But since I can create something for sickle cell and somebody's helping me fund it, that's always good. That's okay. Believe it or not, this is something I've been trying to do. My dream piece. I've always wanted to work with puzzle pieces in my art. But laser cutting and getting the supplies is like thousands of dollars. Could never afford that. So this is a chance, once in a lifetime chance, for me to create one of the pieces I've always dreamed about. But I wanted it to be, you know, more, some of the pretty pieces I make, the colorful pieces I make, the one with women and tropical colors, flowers and all that kind of tropical stuff from Haiti, and that's what it should be. But I'm dealing with a topic that is also important, but it's not as pretty. It's not something you just do for aesthetics. It's a message, it's important, it's something you're fighting. So I guess everything I do boils down to this sometimes. So yeah, that's why my Patreon is there, for people to support me. But I need thousands of people, not just one person. I feel bad that they're donating for 3 years, $20 and stuff, and nothing is getting done because it's only one person, you know? I don't like taking advantage of my friends. One thing about this stuff is, like, you can't be too proud. You have to be able to ask for help. Even if you have you do have a mind, and sometimes you get prideful. If I asked for help all the time, I would never have had troubles that I've always had. When you're alone, you're by yourself, and the name of the piece that I created back then is Need Not Suffer Alone. It's just part of the history of my life and how you always want somebody there when you're dealing with pain. But not all of us are fortunate enough to have family and people who got our back to advocate for us and to take care of us when we are sick and unable to help ourselves. So yeah, it's a hard lesson to learn to ask for help, to be able to trust someone to help you when you're not able to talk for your own, to speak out and fight for yourself. For now, let's try to fix this mess we have. Friend. Hopefully this never comes up again. You don't want air bubbles, that's one of those things. But what I was trying to avoid is all the paint dripping on the side, dripping, all these drips on the side. Because then I have to sand it down and try to make it fit into the puzzle piece, the whole puzzle. It's 24 pieces, so they need to fit together properly, or the work is ruined. So, I have to be careful of the sides, but I also don't need this to lift off. It needs to stay. Stay where it is. Tap for air bubbles. Air bubbles, where are you? Where's the other spot? That was lifting off. There's a little spot here. Spot somewhere. Yep. All right. This corner. thought I felt air bubbles somewhere, but all right here. Dry set, translucent, and matte. But the most important part, it needs to stick to the back. So no air bubble. So I keep doing layers of this anyway. Take a little tour of what's going on so far. So, the whole piece. Where these fit. And again, I said they're hidden, but I'll show that in the next video later on. It's a good start, good start. Next part. Been going as long as I thought I was, but at least I got almost an hour done of work. It's been smooth. Even though I didn't play any music, it's been good. Expecting a lot of air bubbles in this. Getting the canvas size right has been a pain because I had to reorder my canvas prints twice. And they take about a week to ship, so if I reorder it again just to get my size even smaller, that's like another week delay. I just decided, even though I wanted this canvas a little smaller, it's gonna be a little chain, a little larger. Oh my, this is gonna be a problem. Since I did this last night with low light, I'm gonna have issues with air bubbles. I feel a lot of them. It's because I had to restick this. My vision was not
That's why I don't work at night. Can't see. I don't have enough lighting here. Buying lights is expensive. So this one probably is the worst with the bubbles. You can see them. Just to pop the bubbles, I just want to make a little hole for the air to escape. And then I'm going to paint all that after I cut. This is going to be gross. Cut yourself doing this mess. That's it. Well, that's good. Seems like an elbow right here, so it's not cutting. Might have to switch them. Time to.
puzzles have strange shapes. That's because I don't want to use the genuine jigsaw puzzle shapes, because you know, you don't want to mess with copyrights, somebody's trademark or whatever. You want to design your own thing. So most of the shapes you see, even though they're familiar, they have differences, and the shapes are freehand drawn by me, designed by me, so that there's no issues in the future. These are my shapes. So I had to get them specially cut, laser cut. I did buy a saw, but I'm not able to put it together yet, because there's going to be a lot of pieces I'm going to do in the future that doesn't have to do with sickle, so it doesn't have to do with this message. Just fun stuff. It's time for me to have some fun. Not that I'm not enjoying working on art. This is important. Tell you what, when you deal with depression and you stay in bed all the day, or you have insomnia, you can't sleep at night, no matter what you're painting, it is far better to do that and to think about life and feeling bad and all that kind of stuff, because this is good spirituality right here. Meditating and doing things, creative things, keep your mind going. That's always the best part of spirituality, I think. Meditating. Taking time for yourself and all that kind of stuff. Color in a coloring book if you can't draw and stuff like that. Take your mind off stupid stuff. There are so many air bubbles in this. I'm not happy. I'm not happy at all. Edge is not where I want it to be. created the Sickle Cell series after spending 2 weeks in the hospital and being discharged and still having pain. Back in the day, in the 90s and the 80s and stuff, when I used to get sick, it used to be more about insurance, if you can afford it. They used to have this thing where they just discharge you, even if you're not better. After 2 weeks, if you're not feeling better, if you're still having pain after 2 weeks, even though that pain management sucked, they would just discharge you, still feeling sick, still in pain. So I got discharged, still feeling sick, still in pain. I went home frustrated that night. And I took some of my art supplies that I was gonna do some beautiful pieces, you know, tropical colors and Haitian art with the black board that I had and my oil pastels. That night, I was living at this little, one little bedroom rent. In this house, I was renting a little bedroom. And I painted two of these pieces about my pain, sickle cell. About sickle cell. So, a year later, I created the third one. But it's an interesting story. Even though these things been around for a long time, people are rediscovering them now and using them and asking for t-shirts and stuff like that. Of course, there's some people that think, you're taking advantage of the sickle cell community. Some, you know, hurt people type of thing. When they're hurting, they want to hurt you. So they're thinking I use this to make money. Like, I live in a place that I pay $300 rent because I was homeless. And this place is for artists, so you have to create art when you live here. But I don't even have the money for the supplies most of the time, so. Don't take it for granted that I still work on sickle cell and I still use my work for advocacy, because I'm sacrificing a lot just to keep working on sickle cell. So don't be saying I'm using my art to make money off sickle cell, because that's some bullshit right there. You don't know my pain, you don't know what I've been through. I definitely deserve to use the word warrior. That's what I am. Been there. Been doing this for a while. Surviving is good, though. There's so many of us that don't get to make it this far. So can't take it for granted. So that's why you have to still work on this stuff, even if you... Because things are not getting as better as been fighting for people not to get kicked out of emergency rooms, and people are still getting kicked out and treated badly in emergency rooms and all that kind of stuff. No matter how many years pass, it's still getting kicked out of hospitals before their pains are treated. So, yeah. Time to switch, get some more of that.
have hundreds of these blades, but I've already used like dozens of them on this piece. Because once they go dull, when they dull, since I'm cutting fabric, if you leave loose threads, are not good, because then it's gonna mess your stuff up later. So you need sharp cuts, make sure everything stays together. So you don't use dull blades. Before I got these things laser cut, I used to have to cut my puzzle pieces on my own with these blades. All my fingers used to have cuts, my whole hand. You try to use these sharp things with being blind in one eye, not being able to see perspective. It's kind of rough. I'm gonna run out of light soon. The sun is gonna go down in a little bit. At least. Nah, maybe. I have 2 hours, maybe an hour left. It's about to be six. I think the sun doesn't go. Hopefully not. Until 7 or 8. East Coast, Connecticut time. Should take a break. My back hurt sitting here but this thing has so many air bubbles. I need to fix it before the light goes down. The longer I keep it with all this air, the stronger the bond is. I can't fix it after that. One thing about working on a major art project is staying focused. Because if something's gonna take you 6 months to do, it's really hard to stay focused on it. Especially when everybody wants you to be distracted or wants you to be somewhere else or in a different mind frame. It's hard to get your stuff done. Most people don't work on things that take 6 months or whatever, or a year. A lot of people have projects, but I think it's mostly creative people who have long-term stuff. This is definitely not a 9-to-5. Can't really stop thinking about it until it's done. Spend 8 months designing something.
probably the easiest cut of the piece because it's a straight line. Well, that's where I'm having trouble because this thing is stuck to the sides. Congratulations. Well, and leave me a big fat air bubble right here on the side. Thank you. So much. One thing about art is that it's a craft, but to keep your craft and your skills sharp, you have to work every day. And when you can't work every day, you can't afford to work every day on your art. Your skills suffer. And you have to relearn everything when you start doing a new piece. Basically, that's what I deal with sometimes. It's like, man, you used to be good at this. Now you suck. It's a restart. Yeah, your skills, just like the knife, or like the exacto knife. It's gonna get dull. But unlike the exacto knife, the exacto knife gets dull because you use it. But your art skills, they get dull because you don't really have supplies, so you're doing other stuff. Yeah, my video game skills are on point. My social media skills are on point. All those distractions, yeah, those skills are good. But my art skills, not where I want it to be. Sometimes it's like, it would be nice if there was no internet, no distractions, and you had all the money in the world to create art. Just create art. But that's the problem, right? I don't have free money. So, if you're working for clients, they're picking what topic you are working on. This may not always be the topic you want to work on. Keep it together right here. Just a little more. My back is too tired right now. One thing about it is, when you're creating art, when you're an artist, you can only express you. And I think that's what is more important. Not about how much money you can make. For some artists, that might be the case. That's where they see the success. But for me, I think it's cool that even though people may say, hey, you're a sickle cell artist or whatever, which has always felt like a diss to me, disrespectful of my work. Because I'm an artist, not a sickle cell artist. I was born with sickle cell, but I don't want to choose it to have impact on everything I am. It's not what I am. It's not who I am. That's why I don't like the word sickler. Because that's not who I am. And when you have your art says everything about you. What influences your life. And that's why sickle cell plays a big part of my art, because it has a lot of influence on how I feel every day. Because that's my blood. I can't reject my own blood, you know? That's your DNA, that's your coding, that's everything. So when you have an illness that's genetic, rejecting it is rejecting yourself in so many ways. It's not healthy. That's why I get depressed a lot, because you're fighting your own body all the time. It's very hard for people dealing with a disease to feel comfortable in their own body, because their own body is rejecting their pursuit of happiness, their life. You know, that makes a lot of things difficult when you're fighting something so personal. So no, I'm not a sickle cell artist. I'm just an artist that just happens to have sickle cell. And that just impacts my art in so many ways. I've seen other painters out there with sickle cell. They don't deal with the topic that much. I just kind of fell into it. Talk about emotions and how artists feel when they work. And it's like, for me, it's like, you know, when they, that saying, people carry their heart on their sleeve and stuff. I don't know where I carry my heart, but yeah, you feel everything. You're like a sponge, man. It's like you watch the news and all these bad things happen, not ever good news. You soak in all the negative stuff. It's draining. And I keep trying to tell people about empathy and how you feel. How you can put yourself in somebody else's situation and feel their pain and their suffering, their feelings. How would you feel in that situation? This world is lacking that shit, and it's like, that's why you're able to take a life so easily, kill, because you don't have no damn empathy. Somebody's suffering, you think they're seeking drugs, and it's like, dude, just give them the damn freaking drugs. You don't know what they're dealing with. Stop trying to protect them from drugs. What the hell are you doing protecting people from drugs? Like, for real? That's what we focused on, the war on drugs. Like, really? Really? That's the big problem? Not climate change? No, a war on drugs. People can't kill themselves. People can't do this stuff. Like, really? Let people be. It's better than going out there. People should be free to do what they need to do in order to cope with life. Let them cope. But now they're bad. We're getting a lot of backlash. That's why people are so frustrated they go out and do so many things to other people instead of dealing with their own issues. They're just lashing out because they feel like they're justifying their actions and shit. Like they're not. They're just becoming sick and tired of so many outside forces coming in and telling them, you can't do this, you can't do that. You need to hate that person, you need to hate this group. We're teaching people the wrong ideals. That's what happens when I have some pain and discomfort. I try to think about shit. So I'm talking because I'm feeling pain. And it's not really sickle cell pain, it's pain from sitting this position too long. I gotta get this stuff done. And I could have gotten it done in a better position. I gotta get it done in front of a camera so I can document that I'm doing this. It's kind of weird. If I had my choice, I don't know if I would be filming everything. But that's one of the requirements for the project. It feels good when you plan something out, you design something for a couple months, you start working on it, and it starts coming together. Even though I do have a lot of setbacks on this. But this is working. Nothing fatal yet. Nothing project destroying yet. Just air bubbles I have to deal with. Let's deal with those. Bubbles up the yang. thing about working with this thing, it's like it gets stuck to my finger and it's just transparent, flaky. But then I need to use my finger. So I don't wanna build up flakes on the artwork either. Music in my brain right now. Just want to relax listening to some music while you work instead of silence and driving you nuts. Just dry for a little while. There's not much I can do. Air bubble right here, hoping that this will soak in, take care of it. It's the best I can do for the day. It's getting cloudy and not enough light for me
to do much else. Just gonna take a couple pictures. Okay, I think I did good today. Did all right. I'll have to let this dry for a while. These pieces are hidden, so... This goes under that piece right here. It fits right there. See, this is gonna be a piece on top of it. Because there's a map of the world. Let this thing go off. All right, that's it for today. That's how big this piece is. That's why it's gonna take the rest of the year. This part right there, that fits in there. Goes right here. It's all planned out. This goes there. Goes under there. That goes here. And that. That's the top. That's the bottom. So. It goes in here. I could put them in there right now, but they're not dry. And I do want to paint the top of them to protect them. And all of this has to be painted. All of this is going to be painted. So I'll show that in another video in the coming months. Peace and thank you for watching. Share it for sickle cell awareness. Comment, whatever. Patreon, it might be closed, so you don't have to support me there. Peace.